When we think about retrieval practice and pulling information out of our heads, as opposed to trying to cram information into our heads with rereading or lecturing, retrieval practice is so powerful for a few different reasons. One of them is that it helps us use what we know, sort of the idea of use it or lose it. By retrieving what we know, we're pulling it out, we're thinking about it, as opposed to just sort of passively paying attention to a lecture or just rereading something. A second reason why retrieval practice is so effective for long-term learning is what we call desirable difficulties. That internal challenge of having to think back and remember what we did last weekend or the name of the fourth president of the United States, that sort of challenge or struggle improves learning as well. So when we reread, we're just kind of doing it without really having to be engaged or challenged. We're just cramming that information in. And that challenge or difficulty of pulling information out, that retrieval practice, makes a big difference. A third reason why retrieval practice is so effective is that it really shifts our metacognition. So when we retrieve information, we have a better sense of what we know and what we don't know. If we're rereading information over and over, students tend to have this feeling of what we call fluency, or a feeling of confidence that, oh yeah, I just reread that over and over, so I definitely know that information, it's fresh in my mind. And that can be true in the short term. So we know that students cram and it works. You can get really good grades on an exam the next day. But soon after, students forget a lot of that information. So when we engage in retrieval practice, it helps us realize, gee, I didn't know that as well as I thought I knew it. And again, it plays into that difficulty. By challenging what we know, we realize, wow, I really need to study something more often, or I need to continue retrieving to check my understanding.